Hello, good afternoon to all of you. I hope all of you are doing well. So in today's class, we are going to discuss few of the notable microprocessors that were released. These microprocessors are categorized into four different categories. 4-bit microprocessor, 8-bit microprocessor, 16 and 32-bit microprocessor. So we are going to start with the microprocessor description. So the first microprocessor that we're going to discuss is Intel 4004. So Intel 4004 is a 4-bit microprocessor that was introduced on November 15, 1971. It had a clock rate of 740 kHz. It had a capability of 0.07 million instructions per second. The width of the bus was 4 bits. It was multiplexed in order to limit the number of pins. Now, it was based on P-type metal oxide semiconductor technology. It had 2,300 transistors at 10 micrometers. The addressable memory was of 640 bytes, and program memory was around 4 kilobytes. Now, the next microprocessor that we're going to discuss is an 8-bit microprocessor called as Intel 8008. So, 8008 was introduced on April 1st, 1972. It had a clock rate of 500 kHz. It had a capability of 0.05 million instructions per second. The width of bus was 8 bits. It was again multiplexed in order to limit the number of pins. It was based on enhanced load PMOS logic. It had 3,500 transistors at 10 micrometer. The size of the addressable memory was 16 kilobyte, and it was used in general calculator and dumb terminals. Now, the next 8-bit microprocessor that we're going to discuss is Intel 8080. It was introduced on 1st of April 1974 with a clock rate of 2 megahertz. It had a capability of 0.64 million instructions per second. The width of the bus was 8 bit for data and 16 bit for address. Again, multiplex address rate lines in order to limit the number of pins. It was based on enhanced load NMOS logic. The number of transistors was 6000. It was made download compatible to 8008, and the size of the addressable memory was 64 kilobyte, and it had a performance 10 times that of 8008. Now, the next 8-bit microprocessor that we are going to discuss is 8085. 8085 was introduced on March of 1976. It had a clock rate of 3 megahertz with a capability of 0.37 million instructions per second. The width was width of the bus was 8 bit for data and 16 bit for address. Again, it was a multiplex address data line to limit the number of pins. It was based on depletion load NMOS logic. It had 6,500 transistors at 3 micrometer. It was download compatible to 8080. Now, let us move on to 16-bit processors. The first 16-bit processor that we're going to discuss is 8086. Now, 8086 was introduced on June 8, 1978. It was introduced in different versions. So, there were three instances. So, the clock rate was 4.77 megahertz with 0.33 million instructions per second, 8 megahertz with 0.66 million instructions per second, 10 megahertz with 0.75 million instructions per second. Now, in case of 8086 or 8086, the memory was divided into even bank and odd bank. So, so in order to enable access to both the banks simultaneously, in situation where 16-bit data is to be read in one clock cycle. Now, the width of the bus was 16 for data and 20 for address. Again, it was multiplex address data line to limit the number of pins. It had 29,000 transistors at 3 micrometer. The size of the addressable memory was 1 megabyte. And it was, and it had a performance 10 times that of 8080. And it used the segment registers to access more than 64 kilobyte of data at once. Now, the next 16-bit microprocessor that we're going to discuss is 8088. So, 8088 was introduced on 1st of June, 1979. Clock rate, it had different versions. So, 4.77 megahertz with 0.33 MIPS. and 8 MHz with 0.75 MIPS. Now, it had an internal architecture of 16-bit, but the external bus width was 8-bit for data, 20-bit for address. So, in order to access 16-bit, it had to go for two successive cycles. So, this made 8088 a little weaker than that of 8086. It had 29,000 transistors at 3 micrometer. The size of the addressable memory was 1 megabyte. It's identical to 8086 except that it has an 8-bit external bus. And it was used in IBM PC and PC clones, right? Now, the next 16-bit microprocessor that we're going to discuss is 80186. So, 80186 was introduced in 1982. It had a clock rate of 6 MHz with more than 1 million instructions per second, capability of more than 1 million instructions per second. The number of transistors was around 29,000 at 2 micrometer. Now, it included two timers, a DMA controller and an interrupt controller. So, we're going to discuss the role of DMA controller and interrupt controller, that is direct memory access and interrupt controller, so in the upcoming chapters. So for now, you just remember that it included two timers, that is DMA controller and interrupt controller, on the chip in addition to the processor. Now, it had a few extended capability compared to that of 8086 in terms of opcode, and it was mostly used in embedded applications. And it was later renamed as IAPX-1H6. Now, the next 16-bit microprocessor that we're going to discuss is 80188. It's a version of 80186 with 8-bit external data bus. Later, it was named as IAPX-188. Now, the next microprocessor that we're going to discuss is 16-bit microprocessor that we're going to discuss is 80286. Now, 80286 was introduced on 1st of February 1982. It had very different versions. So, clock rate was 6 MHz with 0.9 MIPS, 8 MHz, 10 MHz with 1.5 MIPS, 12.5 MHz with 2.6 MIPS, and 16 and 20 MHz and 25 MHz versions as well. Now, the width of the bus was 16-bit for data and 24-bit for address because it had greater addressable memory location. So, it included memory protection hardware to support multitasking operating system with pre-processed address space. So this is one of the features that 80286 had in it. It had around 1,34,000 transistors at 1.5 micrometer. The size of the addressable memory was 16 megabyte. And it had 3 to 6 time performance of that of 8086. Now, the next microprocessor that we're going to discuss is the 32-bit microprocessor. So the first 32-bit microprocessor that we're going to discuss is 80386DX. It was introduced on October 17, 1985. It had different versions. So 16 MHz with 5 to 6 MIPS, 20 MHz with 6 to 7 MIPS, and 25 MHz with 8.5 MIPS, and 33 MHz with 11.4 MIPS, right? So these were the various microprocessors under 80386 with different capabilities. So the width of the bus was 32-bit for data and 32-bit for address. And the number of transistors was 2,75,000 at 1 micrometer. The size of the addressable memory was 4 gigabytes. And virtual memory of 64 TB. It was the first generation of 86 processor chip to handle 32-bit data set. So as we discussed, this was the first 32-bit microprocessor that was there, 80386. So now let us move on to the next microprocessor that we have, a 32-bit microprocessor that we have is 80486. It was introduced on April 10th, 1989. It was released in different versions. So the clock rates were 25 MHz with 20 MIPS, 33 MHz with 27 MIPS, 50 MHz with 41 MIPS. The width of the bus was 32 bits. The number of transistors was 1.2 million at 1 micrometer. And the size of the addressable memory was 4 gigabyte. Virtual memory was of 1 terabyte. It had a coprocessor on it for mathematical operations. And it had a performance 50 times that of 8088. And it was used in desktop computing and servers. So these were the few of the notable microprocessors that were released. There are several other microprocessors that were released, but I found these are a few of the notable microprocessors that one needs to remember, and the way how they are categorized and with their capabilities. So in today's class, we have come across different 4-bit microprocessor, 8-bit microprocessor, 16-bit microprocessor, and 32-bit microprocessor with different capabilities. So here, the only objective was to show with time how the capability of the microprocessor has enhanced with the advancement in technology. So thank you very much for today's class. We'll continue with the description of the microprocessor in the next class.